Good morning, Burton families and guests. My name is Jorge Rios, and I'm the proud principal here at Burton Street Elementary School. On behalf of the staff, I welcome you to our second virtual culmination. Thank you for being present today. Our students, your children, have been waiting for almost 180 days for this event, their culmination. And although this event is affected by the events around the world in our day, there is nothing that can stop us from taking this time to celebrate the great accomplishments of our fifth graders in this very moment. Here at Burton, we know that we always strive for excellence in everything we do. And we are now discovering that this motto has been instrumental in carrying us through these difficult times. Buenos días, familias e invitados de Burton. Mi nombre es Jorge Rios y soy el orgulloso director de Burton Street Elementary. En nombre del personal, les doy la bienvenida a nuestra segunda culminación virtual. Gracias por su presencia. Nuestros estudiantes, sus hijos, han estado esperando por casi 180 días por este evento. Su culminación. Aunque nuestro evento sea afectado por los eventos en todo el mundo en nuestros días, no hay nada que pueda evitar que nos tomemos este tiempo para celebrar los grandes logros de nuestros alumnos de quinto grado en este mismo momento. Aquí en Burton sabemos que siempre nos esforzamos para lograr la excelencia en todo lo que hacemos. Y ahora estamos descubriendo que este lema también nos ha sido fundamental para llevarnos a través de estos tiempos difíciles. Fifth graders, please receive my sincere best wishes for a successful middle school experience. Your success in middle school is in your control. Although you leave elementary knowing how to read, how to do math, and how to be a good friend, you will encounter some difficult days in middle school. When this happens, you will have to make a choice. You will either choose to give up or you will choose to keep trying. Giving up is easy. To keep trying involves asking questions, taking deep breaths to avoid becoming frustrated. And most importantly, believing that you can resolve your difficulties. Please promise yourself that you will always try before giving up. If you keep that promise, success will always be within your reach. Fifth graders, I wish you good luck today, tomorrow, and always. Estudiantes de quinto grado, mis mejores deseos para una experiencia de escuela secundaria con éxito. Su éxito en la escuela secundaria está bajo su control. Aunque salen de la escuela primaria sabiendo leer, cómo hacer matemáticas, cómo ser un buen amigo, ustedes encontrarán días difíciles en la escuela secundaria. Cuando esto suceda, tendrán que tomar una decisión. ¿Van a optar por renunciar o van a optar por seguir intentándolo? Renunciar es fácil. Seguir intentando implicará hacer preguntas cuando no entienden algo, tomar un suspiro profundo para evitar la frustración y creer que pueden solucionar sus dificultades si se aplican a ello. Prométanse a sí mismos que siempre van a intentar antes de darse por vencidos. Si mantienen esta promesa, el éxito siempre estará a su alcance. Estudiantes de quinto grado, les deseo buena suerte hoy, mañana y siempre.
great privilege that I stand here today in front of parents, teachers, and the fifth grade class of 2021. I have known most of you since kindergarten, and some I have just met. Matter how long I have known you, I stand here today with conviction that all of you can make the right choices, follow your passions, and realize that dreams do come true. Remember, you will make mistakes. Learn from them and carry on. You have now lived through a global pandemic, and as challenging as it has been, you have become stronger and more capable and have different skills that will help you succeed. I believe that I am looking at future doctors, lawyers, teachers, engineers, or some new job that has not even been created yet. It doesn't matter the career you choose. What matters is that you find passion and joy of not only your career, but in your daily life as well. In the words of Dr. Seuss, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. And now, it is my honor to introduce our first valedictorian for Miss Aggie Pogu's class, Yenesis Solis.
It is my pleasure to welcome students, families, and faculty to Culmination Day at Burton. Every one of you have made an impact on the fifth graders who are now on their way to sixth grade here today. These past 7 years at Burton have been crazy, but fun. And I would like to thank the teachers for being there for us, making sure we did all the work, but mostly for them still trying their best, even in this pandemic, to make sure that we could achieve and that we do awesome in fifth grade. I would also like to congratulate the kids who tried their best this year and did all of their work because it really paid off. What we went through was really hard and part of history, but we really did our best. Some of my favorite memories I had here at Burton was when our teachers would put these exercise videos for us to do, but most of the time we were just goofing around and laughing. Through all the years at Burton, we got to go to many field trips, but my all-time favorite was the 24th Street Theater because I really enjoyed seeing the plays with my friends and classmates. I have a lot of memories at Burton, and I will never forget them, but everything comes to an end. I'd like to thank the school for making me become who I am today. Burton Elementary has made me become more outgoing and less shy. Without my best friends and classmates, I wouldn't be here right now, talking to you and congratulating you on your culmination. So once again, thank you.
This is one of your proud assistant principals, Mrs. Stone. I would like to congratulate you on completing your time here with us at Burton and culminating. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Nelson Mandela said that, and it is important for you to know that today. Take all that you have learned from us and put it towards good use as you move forward to middle school. Thank you, parents and families, for supporting your students while they were here with us, and continue to help your students grow and shine in the years to come. Congratulations, Burton Bears, and may the best only be beginning.
Good morning, I'm Mrs. Gorlick-Mara. Welcome, parents, staff, and our culminating class of 2021. Congratulations to our Burton Bears, our class of 2021. You have persevered and done so much in these challenging times during this past year. Continue to always try your best in middle, high school, and college. There is nothing that you cannot do. You are known by the company you keep, so choose your friends wisely. We are so proud of you and look forward to hearing about your future achievements. I am pleased to introduce the students who are speaking about how Burton has inspired them.
Betsai Ardon.
Burton has inspired me to work hard and go to college to become an FBI agent to keep everyone safe.
Linda Flores.
Burton has inspired me to become a responsible and kind person. It has also helped me throughout the year to be a very great person in the world.
Chris Butch.
Burton has inspired me to strive for excellence and work hard to achieve my dreams.
George Monroy.
Burton has inspired me to learn, and I also appreciate the teachers who helped me learn while I was at Burton.
Crystal Santiago.
Burton has inspired me to be kind to others and know whatever comes in my way, I can handle it and just leave it in the past.
Dayanara Cruz.
Burton has inspired me to be kind to everyone and take charge and share.
Joseph Collins Lapid.
Burton has inspired me to be a smart, good person and to learn.
Genesis Solis Rivas.
Burton inspired me to be respectful and nice to other people, as well as treat them how you want to be treated.
Johnny Patiño.
Burton has inspired me to wake up and be ready to learn.
Good morning. I'm Ms. Gasser. Congratulations to the Burton Culminating Class of 2021. We are so proud of you and all you've achieved. In the words of Walt Disney, if you can dream it, you can do it. You've proven yourselves. Dream on. Here are just some of Burton's fifth graders sharing their hopes and dreams for the future. Congratulations.
Sara Lopez.
In the future, I see myself in the front doors of the state capitol. As governor, I will make state laws that will help and defend California and make it a safer place for people to live in.
Valeria Pimentel.
In the future, I see myself going to college and becoming a professional singer.
Sebastian Perez.
In the future, I want to be a gamer and I want to live stream on YouTube.
Lilin Valiente.
I would like to thank all my teachers and my parents for always making sure that we were on the right track, especially in the tough time. Thank you for not giving up on us. Burton Elementary School is like the second home to me. It helps me grow and I made a lot of friends. In the future, I see myself as an animator to entertain people in my cartoons, since I like to draw a cartoony way and that's my dream job. I'll never forget this school.
Ethan Brill Ellis.
My dream for the future is to be in the military like my grandpa.
Miguel Alas.
I see myself in the future walking through the hallways of Yale as I prepare to become a doctor and perform surgery on people.
Victor Frankie Orejel.
In the future, I see myself having my own restaurant and making gourmet food. I will help feed the poor with food from my restaurant.
Ada Garcia.
In my future, I will be a teacher and taking animals.
Christopher Paredes.
Hi, I'm Christopher, and I want to be police and
how other people say my mom and everyone because it meant to me, and thank you.
Karemi Gambos.
In the future, I see myself at my 10th.
Hi, my name is Miss Miller. I'm the resource teacher at Burton Street Elementary School. I want to say congratulations to our Burton class of 2021. It has been a pleasure seeing you grow in knowledge, goodness toward others, and academic ability. Keep trying your best in every area of your life and success will follow you. Don't forget to nurture your creativity and join to your creativity or expanding academic knowledge. Creativity makes our world more beautiful. It entertains us, builds, improves, and solves problems and finds solutions. I'm so excited for the future, positive impact each one of you can make in our world in these ways. It has been a tremendous joy and privilege to work with each one of my students. And I am also pleased to introduce the students who will be speaking about how their creativity will impact the future.
Brisa Alamillo Gonzalez.
My creativity will help create entertainment that will inspire and encourage people to succeed.
Emily Suniga.
My creativity will inspire me to make comic books and books. It makes me so happy to entertain.
Rosie Erasso.
My creativity will lead me to be the best person I could ever be and also entertain people by making art and animations.
Robbie Pineda.
My creativity will help me become a scientist and make vaccines that will cure diseases.
Aaron Romero Garcia.
My creativity will help me to say hello to my future classes and write entertaining stories for them.
Denim Bouillard.
My creativity will help me design robots. My creativity will help me keep people safe.
Noel Sanchez.
My creativity will help me design a plan to end poverty.
Ramon Paciente Jr.
My creativity will lead me to become a doctor that will find a cure for viruses.
David Rodriguez.
Creativity will help me become a race car driver in NASCAR.
Class of 2021. Congratulations as your elementary years come to a close. I am grateful for having the opportunity to be your teacher. You are now going forward to make your impact on the world. You may not realize it, but you made your first impact from the moment you were born and brought so much joy to your family. Then you made an impact here at Burton as students on Zoom who persevered, connecting every day to hear your teacher's voice and engaging learning as best you could. Whether it was sharing a room with siblings and keeping headphones on, or facing the challenge to find a quiet place in your home, some of you took us on car rides, doing your best to answer questions. Then came the courageous few who made your impact in person as we returned to unknown measures as we took the first steps into bringing the pandemic to a close. You showed up and you did your best. You were resilient. Your impact here was that you never gave up and you modeled for the rest of the world that learning is possible anywhere and everywhere. All of you made an impact on me with your smiles, laughter, silly jokes,
Obama speeches, and your sweetness and caring gestures that I will keep in my heart forever. I will miss you because you have been a class like no other. You inspired me every day with your stories about goals and plans for the future. Your willingness to make an impact with change for our planet is impressive. I wish you the best and to continue striving for excellence. Amazing fifth graders, go and make your impact on the world. I now leave you with the fifth graders who will share how they plan to make their impact on our planet.
Angel Solis.
My impact on the planet will be to help the ill people of the world by finding a cure for cancer and helping them have a normal life.
Brianna Navarro.
My impact on the planet will be to help others and the people who have no food. I will go to the homeless people and give them food and give them stuff to survive.
Fabian Calderon.
My impact on the planet will be to always recycle and encourage other people to do the same. This will make our planet cleaner and safer for humans and animals for years to come.
Joseph Villalta.
My impact on the planet will be to research marine life and find ways to keep our oceans healthy and beautiful.
Jesus Arreola.
My impact on the planet will be to find new fish in the ocean and stop sea pollution as a marine biologist.
Luis Delgadillo.
My impact on the planet will be to invent keyboards that can type with your mind, not your hands.
Joshua Valenzuela.
My impact on the planet as a medical doctor will be to find a cure for COVID-19.
Darlene Coyoy.
My impact on the planet will be a governor, then I will be able to help people.
Kaden Fernando.
My impact on the planet as a professional basketball player will be to build basketball courts around the world and make the game of basketball accessible to everyone.
English Holler.
Congratulations to all of our fifth graders moving on to middle school. Some might say this year was challenging. And a matter of fact, this year presented many new challenges. Challenges the world hasn't seen in over 100 years. And yet we have done something amazing this year. You have made history this year. Distance learning will be something that future generations read about in their history books, just as you have read about challenges of the past in your history books this year. And through all of it, you have demonstrated amazing perseverance. You have met the challenge, and some of you completely on your own, to learn from home. Through the laggy Wi-Fi and all of it, you met the challenge to study in your kitchen, read in your bed, and Zoom from the living room. And it was fun. For the first time ever, I got to see all my students' Christmas trees. And we became experts in many things. Things we might not have ever thought about learning about, like Percy and Pear Deck, or breakout rooms, or each other's pets, Google Classroom and Schoology alike. And there were bigger challenges too. We also had to navigate being apart. Apart from our friends, and our school community had to find a way to thrive in a new setting. And sometimes it was hard, and even lonely. But every morning, at the early hour of 9 a.m., we were there and we showed up for each other on Zoom. So I say, yeah, this year was challenging, but that's what made it great. You grew stronger because together we faced the challenges of distance learning, and together we could navigate the fears of being on video, much like I'm doing right now. And chat became our best friend, and we figured out how to collaborate and learn in a digital space. And you did an amazing job preparing for middle school. So when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Fail or succeed, when you overcome the challenges that life throws at you, you become stronger. And even though we didn't sign up for the challenges that life brought on this year, if you stop and think for a moment, I bet every single one of you can find something that made you stronger this year. But you might have to look at things from a different perspective, just to see how it changed you, to see how you grew, to see what you learned. You might have learned something about yourself that you weren't expecting to learn, something you didn't know was there. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." Fifth graders, the future is yours. I challenge you to make your dreams a reality, to live and grow strong. Take the resilience you built this year and believe in yourself, find your perspective, and achieve the dream. And here are a few of our fifth graders ready to share the challenges their dreams will lead them to take on.
Elmer Gueso.
I want to take on the challenge to make entertaining things for people and make new technology and help people throughout the world. I want to send a message to never ever give up and always persevere. And don't let anyone stop you in achieving your dreams.
Matthew Chacon.
I want to take on the challenge to help the world become a cleaner planet by developing alternate forms of energy that can be used by all.
Pedro Mendez.
I want to take on the challenge to gain some knowledge to go to my dream job, that is a car dealer.
Mariah Cardona Argueta.
I want to take on the challenge to become a voice actor because voice actors have inspired me and I would like to entertain others.
Byron Quintanilla.
I want to take on the challenge to become a computer engineer and create artificial intelligence and new inventions that help the environment and people.
Leiden Carlos.
I want to take on the challenge to figure out what lurks in the deep parts of the ocean that have not been explored.
Emily Duarte.
I want to take on the challenge to make the world a better place by treating everyone equally, no matter their race, their gender, their religion, or who they love.
Axel Cruz.
I want to take on the challenge to help clean our oceans. I want to be a volunteer and help clean our beaches.
Edwin Bonilla.
I want to take on the challenge to be successful and stay optimistic during bad times, such as right now, but I will always try my best to succeed.
Congratulations to our culminating fifth grade students. I want to say how proud I am of all our scholars. They are coming to an end of one part of a journey, but of course the beginning of a much larger one. It will be filled with challenges, but if there's one thing I know about you, having seen many of you since kindergarten, you've got perseverance. You know what struggle looks like. And you know what overcoming struggle looks like as well. You have so in many academic achievements. But academic achievements are only part of what you've accomplished. You've grown socially and emotionally. You demonstrated competency and mastery under less than ideal circumstances. But nevertheless, we have seen many students rise to the challenge. Which brings me to the recipients of our presidential awards. It is with great honor that I present the awards to the following students. From Ms. Gordick's class, the Silver Presidential Award goes to Christopher Paredes. From Ms. Gasser's class, the Silver Presidential Award goes to Ethan Brill Ellis. From Ms. Serenine's class, the Silver Presidential Award goes to Angel Solis and Caden Fernando. From Ms. Serenine's class, the Gold Presidential Award goes to Emily Duarte and English Holler. From Ms. Aggie Pogo's class, the Silver Presidential Award goes to Emily Suniga and Joseph Colin Lapid. From Ms. Aggie Pogo's class, the Gold Presidential Award goes to Linda Flores and Rosalind Erazo. I want to congratulate once again all our fifth grade students. And now I would like to introduce our valedictorian from Ms. Serenine's class, Fabian Calderon.
Thank you, Mr. Rios, and thank you to the students, teachers, parents, and staff who made these 7 years at Burton Elementary School happen. I also want to thank Google, Wikipedia, and the inventor of copy and paste. Just kidding. Some of the memorable moments at Burton that I recall are the long but informative Monday morning assemblies, the chocolate cell assemblies, and celebrating my birthday with my class. I remember the good old days playing kickball with my classmates and staff members that would supervise the playground. I think almost everybody in our class misses those moments that are now captured by the notorious COVID-19. Even though we are apart from one another, we have each other's backs. We are like a team, always ready to help each other. Now that our elementary school years are closing, dream big. Do whatever you're trying to do, like becoming a doctor, a basketball player, or whatever job you want to get, you can do it. Barack Obama once said, "Don't just get involved, fight for your seat at the table. Better yet, fight for a seat at the head of the table." In other words, don't give up and always do your best. Eventually, we'll follow our dreams, always remembering Burton Elementary for starting us off into the crazy world of school. Don't think this is the last time you are seeing or hearing your best friend, because you never know when you might meet again. Finally, I leave you with this poem from an unknown author. Goodbyes are not forever. Goodbyes are not the end. They simply mean I'll miss you until we meet again. Congratulations, Burton Bears, class of 2021. Party people, what? It might seem crazy,
what about it? Everybody got their pets?
Have you passed by any cows?
Yes.
Where are you? Are you still in Chicago?
Nah, but I will go.
Aren't you back in Los Angeles?
Yeah.
Hey, who's playing?
Yo, somebody's playing video games.
Do you have Fortnite?
Yes, Microwave.
Do you have Fortnite?
No, I don't have Fortnite.
No.
You have Minecraft.
I don't have Minecraft either.
Come on. Put the dog down and let's go get our math books. Okay, everybody go get your math book. Who has a math book?
Goodbye, I'm leaving. My computer's not working anymore. I'm leaving.
My second growing up.
Okay, Axel, can you answer the question, please? Can anybody interpret the lag?
Okay, boys and girls, can you please take out your math books?
Yes.
Can I call your name? Tell me if you were. Okay,
no. Yes, Miss Serenelle, I have my math book in front of me. I'm ready for you, Miss Serenelle.
Look at Miss Ken.
It's in front of them.
All right, Dad. Let's go and see what's happening with Johnny Tremaine.
I can't believe you're going on to middle school. I'm so proud of you and excited about it.
This one's hard. Give it to me. Answer. Quick, fast. 1 + 1. Go. Anyone?
Are there any real students out there instead of foreheads?
My phone, guys.
No.
Hello. Is there anybody out there, Miss Bree? Are those fries in your hand?
Yes, Paris. What example are you studying with M&M's?
Are you going to share,
Miss Paris?
Obama. Obama Gooder.
Toaster.
Okay, I'm back. Sorry, it's a moment with Mom.
Miss Anna,
Thank you.
hope you enjoyed this culmination. At this point, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to our fifth grade teaching team. Ms. Ada Serenil, Ms. Karen Agipogu, Ms. Robin Gasser, and Ms. Melissa Gorlick-Marr, thank you. I would also like to thank our assistant principals, Ms. Jennifer Stone and Mr. Juan Gonzalez, and our intervention coordinator, Dr. Steinfeld. Special appreciation goes out to Ms. Agipogu for her leadership in orchestrating this event. Espero que hayan disfrutado de esta culminación. En este punto, me gustaría expresar mi más profundo agradecimiento a nuestro equipo de maestros de quinto grado, que son la señora Ada Serenil, la señora Karen Agipogu, la señora Robin Gasser, la señora Melissa Gorlick-Marr, y también quiero agradecer a nuestros subdirectores, la señora Jennifer Stone y el señor Juan González, y nuestra coordinadora de intervención, la doctora Andrea Steinfeld. Un agradecimiento especial a Ms. Agipogu por su liderazgo en organización de este evento. Parents and families, may your children always be blessed with the same amount of love and support that you are showering them with today. Your child's success is also in your control. Daily positive affirmations such as I love you, I'm proud of you, and I believe in you will serve as your child's fuel to achieve their goals and dreams with success. Thank you for joining us today. Padres y familias, que sus hijos siempre sean bendecidos con la misma cantidad de amor y apoyo que les están demostrando hoy. El éxito de sus hijos está también en su control. Afirmaciones positivas diarias tales como te amo y estoy orgulloso de ti y creemos en ti servirán como fuego para que sus hijos puedan lograr sus metas y sus sueños con éxito. Gracias por estar con nosotros hoy.